Thank you, Chairman Lowy, Ranking Member Rogers, and members of the subcommittee. Thank you for the opportunity to represent the Armenian National Committee of America to share our community's fiscal year 2020 foreign assistance priorities. As you know, we deeply value the U.S.-Armenia friendship and were particularly honored last year to be joined by Armenia's new president at an event the ANCA hosted on Capitol Hill, marking a century of U.S.-Armenia relations. Today, with the generous help of our Congress, Armenia is a strong friend of the United States, having sent troops to support our operations in Kosovo and Afghanistan, and working to address a range of regional challenges. Nagorno-Karabakh, with the support of direct U.S. assistance, stands today as a constructive partner in the search for a democratic and lasting peace in the Caucasus. It is in the spirit of friendship and shared democratic values that we come to you with our priorities for the coming fiscal year. First, an allocation of at least $6 million in assistance for Nagorno-Karabakh. We want to thank the subcommittee for its longstanding support for this program dating back to FY98. The HALO Trust, with the support of this subcommittee, is close to declaring Karabakh mine-free, but needs continued funds to complete its life-saving work. In addition to demining, we urge this panel to support the operations of Karabakh-based rehabilitation centers, which serve children, adults, and seniors with physical and mental disabilities. Besides meeting vital needs, U.S. aid to Karabakh also represents a confidence-building measure toward peace and a real investment in freedom. Second, an appropriation of at least $30 million in economic assistance and $10 million in military assistance for Armenia. In the aftermath of Armenia's constitutional political transition and recent free and fair elections, we want to share our special thanks with the subcommittee for its longstanding leadership in fostering the bilateral friendship of our two nations and to seek your continued support for strengthening Armenia's independence. Armenia, a Christian nation deeply rooted in Western democratic values, has emerged, despite dual Turkish and Azerbaijani blockades, as an important regional ally and international partner for the United States on a broad array of complex challenges. As we continue to work with the Trump administration to implement programs that promote U.S.-Armenia bilateral economic relations, such as a double tax treaty, we ask you to help Armenia make the transition from aid to trade by appropriating at least $30 million in economic assistance. Third, an appropriation of $20 million to help Armenia provide transition support to refugees from Syria who found safe haven in Armenia. Armenia has welcomed nearly 25,000 refugees from Syria with only modest levels of U.S. and international relief and resettlement assistance. Armenia has provided full citizenship rights to Armenian Syrian refugees and has sought to compassionately integrate all arriving families into Armenian society, but faces serious financial constraints in meeting the needs of these refugees. Special areas in need of support in terms of short-term housing, job training, and social and economic integration. Our prepared remarks also address the need to strengthen Section 907 of the Freedom Support Act, the imperative of cutting U.S. military aid to an overarmed and belligerent Baku, and the benefits of lowering the barriers to U.S. contacts and communication with the people and government of Karabakh. In the fall of 2017, three members of Congress traveled to Karabakh to see firsthand the life-saving impact of the funds appropriated by Congress. We would welcome additional trips such as this and encourage members of this panel to consider visiting Karabakh. Thank you for your leadership on these important issues.